High blood sugar occurs when your body can't effectively transport sugar from blood into cells. Here are 15 easy ways to lower blood sugar levels naturally. 1. Exercise regularly. Regular exercise can help you lose weight and increase insulin sensitivity. Increased insulin sensitivity means your cells are better able to use the available sugar in your bloodstream. Exercise also helps your muscles use blood sugar for energy and muscle contraction. Good forms of exercise include weightlifting, brisk walking, running, biking, dancing, hiking, swimming and more. 2. Control your carb intake. Your body breaks carbs down into sugars and then insulin moves the sugars into cells. When you eat too many carbs or have problems with insulin function, this process fails and blood glucose levels rise. Many studies also show that a low-carb diet helps reduce blood sugar levels and prevent blood sugar spikes. 3. Increase your fiber intake. Fiber slows carb digestion and sugar absorption. For these reasons, it promotes a more gradual rise in blood sugar levels. A high-fiber diet can help manage type 1 diabetes by improving blood sugar control and reducing blood sugar lows. Foods that are high in fiber include vegetables, fruits, legumes and whole grains. The recommended daily intake of fiber is about 25 grams for women and 38 grams for men. 4. Drink water and stay hydrated. Drinking enough water may help you keep your blood sugar levels within healthy limits. In addition to preventing dehydration, it helps your kidneys flush out the excess blood sugar through urine. Keep in mind that water and other non-caloric beverages are best. Sugar-sweetened drinks raise blood glucose, drive weight gain and increase diabetes. 5. Implement portion control. Portion control helps regulate calorie intake and can lead to weight loss. Here are some helpful tips for controlling portions. Measure and weigh portions. Use smaller plates. Avoid all-you-can-eat restaurants. Read food labels and check the serving sizes. Keep a food journal. Eat slowly. 6. Choose foods with a low glycemic index. Eating low glycemic index foods has been shown to reduce long-term blood sugar levels in type 1 and type 2 diabetics. Although the glycemic index of foods is important, the amount of carbs consumed also matters. Foods with a low glycemic index include seafood, meat, eggs, oats, barley, beans, lentils, legumes, sweet potatoes, corn, yams, most fruits and non-starchy vegetables. 7. Control stress levels. Stress can affect your blood sugar levels. Hormones such as glucagon and cortisol are secreted during stress. These hormones cause blood sugar levels to go up. Exercises and relaxation methods like yoga and mindfulness-based stress reduction can also correct insulin secretion problems in chronic diabetes. 8. Monitor your blood sugar levels. Keeping track helps you determine whether you need to make adjustments in meals or medications. It will also help you find out how your body reacts to certain foods. Try measuring your levels every day, and keeping track of the numbers in a log. 9. Get enough quality sleep. Poor sleeping habits and a lack of rest also affect blood sugar levels and insulin sensitivity. They can increase appetite and promote weight gain. Sleep deprivation decreases the release of growth hormones and increases cortisol levels. Both of these play an important role in blood sugar control. It is best to get a sufficient amount of high-quality sleep every night. 10. Eat foods rich in chromium and magnesium. Chromium-rich foods include egg yolks, whole grain products, high-brand cereals, coffee, nuts, green beans, broccoli and meat. Magnesium has also been shown to benefit blood sugar levels. Magnesium-rich foods include dark leafy greens, whole grains, fish, dark chocolate, bananas, avocados and beans. 11. Try apple cider vinegar. It promotes lower fasting blood sugar levels, possibly by decreasing its production by the liver or increasing its use by cells. What's more, studies show that vinegar significantly influences your body's response to sugars and improves insulin sensitivity. To incorporate apple cider vinegar into your diet, you can add it to salad dressings or mix 2 teaspoons in 8 ounces of water. 12. Experiment with cinnamon extract. 2D show cinnamon can also lower blood sugar levels by up to 29%. It slows the breakdown of carbs in the digestive tract, which moderates the rise in blood sugar after a meal. Cinnamon also acts in a similar way as insulin, although at a much slower rate. An effective dose is 1 to 6 grams of cinnamon per day, or about 0.5 to 2 teaspoons. 13. Try berberine. Berberine has been shown to help lower blood sugar and enhance the breakdown of carbs for energy. Additionally, it may have some side effects. Diarrhea, constipation, flatulence and abdominal pain have been reported. A common dosage protocol for berberine is 1,500 mg per day, taken before meals is 3 doses of 500 mg. 14. Eat fenugreek seeds. Studies have shown that fenugreek can effectively lower blood sugar in diabetics. It also helps reduce fasting glucose and improve glucose tolerance. Fenugreek can easily be added to baked goods to help treat diabetes. You can also make fenugreek flour or brew it into tea. The recommended dose of fenugreek seeds is 2 to 5 grams per day. 15. Lose some weight. Even a 7% reduction in body weight can decrease your risk of developing diabetes by up to 58%, and it seems to work even better than medication. You should also be conscious of your waistline, as it is perhaps the most important weight-related factor for estimating your diabetes risk. Okay, it is time to take action. If you want to learn more about how to reverse diabetes, then please listen carefully. You might not know it, but you're at an important crossroads in your life right now. And you really just have two options, leading to two very different lives. 1. A lifetime of energy and hope and passion for life, where you love your body and are amazed every time you look in the mirror, where you are no longer shackled to diabetes, the medications, the finger pricks and test strips. The other. Well, the other is just a continuation of the life you have now. So, listen closely as I tell you what your two options are so you can make the right choice for you. Option number 1, you can choose to do exactly what the mainstream healthcare system want you to do, and carry on taking your meds. Remember, by doing this you'll never be free from drugs. Diabetes medication was never designed to cure you. It was designed to manage your condition, so that you remain trapped on the medication merry-go-round until the day you die. That's the way the big pharma-backed diabetes treatment system works. It locks you into a lifetime of drug dependency. I think you already know what will happen if you do take this option, because you've felt it so many times before. That feeling of hopelessness. Of being trapped in your body. Of feeling yourself getting heavier and more exhausted and more fed up with your struggle with your weight and with your body every single day. Wondering why it's so hard for you to get in shape and stay in shape. Or feeling guilty because you aren't spending hours and hours at the gym. Every week pedaling as fast as you can but not getting anywhere at all. I know you don't want that. And remember, the average diabetic will spend $283,000 to treat the disease and its complications during the course of their lifetime. That's the financial cost of doing nothing. The human cost is far greater. I'm talking about coma, heart attack, stroke, nerve damage, kidney failure. Cutting your life short by years, even decades. Option number 2. Do something about it. Just imagine the difference this could make to your life. No more fear of a fatal diabetic coma. No more fear of forgetting to take your meds. No more fear of the inevitable worsening of your diabetes over time. No more finger pricks or test strips. No more injections. No more having to deny yourself the foods you love. In a lot of ways, it's the easier road, because all it takes on your part is deciding you love yourself enough to say yes right now. To learn more about what you can do today, simply click on the link in the description below this video. I have quite a few surprises I haven't told you about, but I can't wait for you to see. Learn a simple, tested method that saved Kathy from type 2 diabetes and an early grave. Click on the link in the description below, and I see you there. Thanks for watching my video.